pray Jesus for his grace upon each one of our lives. We welcome you all in Jesus' name to hear the word of God, to receive the love of God, and to become like Christ. Let us pray. Father, we come to you through the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for loving us so much. Thank you, Jesus, for your grace upon each one of our lives. Thank you, dear Holy Spirit of God, for your continual bless. Thank you for your continual presence. Thank you for your continual blessings in our lives. We thank you for what you have done on the cross of Calvary. We are under the blood of Jesus. We thank you for the redemption. We thank you for the sanctification. We thank you for the holiness through your precious blood. Every disturbance, every fear, every obstacle, every plan of Satan be broken in Jesus' name. We are under the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for your lordship in our lives. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your help and guidance. We love you. We bless you. We thank you for your saints and your servants of God in every nation. Thank you for helping us to receive the word, love, from the throne of grace. In Jesus' name, we agree and we pray. Amen. Praise be to Jesus for his grace upon each one. Dear saints and servants of God, we welcome you all in Jesus' name to the School of Discipleship. Today's topic, from the throne of grace, the false prophets and their characteristics. Today's topic, from the throne of grace, the false prophets and their characteristics. Dear saints and servants of God, Lord Jesus loves you. Lord Jesus has a great plan for you and for your family. Lord has chosen fivefold ministers to edify the body of Christ, to strengthen the body of Christ, to build the body of Christ, to win souls for the kingdom of Lord Jesus Christ, for the purification of the body of Christ, and for the comfort of the body of Christ. Praise be to Jesus. Gospel of Mark, chapter 13, verse 22.
For false messiahs and false prophets will rise up and perform signs and wonders so as to deceive, if possible, even God's chosen ones.
Amen. When Christ Jesus was here on this planet Earth, he taught them. Christ Jesus taught many things, many teachings about the kingdom of God, about the false prophets, about false teachers and their characteristics to his chosen disciples, dear saints and servants of God. Lord says, many false messiahs will come, many Christ will come. In the last days, false prophets will arise from east, west, south and the north of the world to deceive people. They do wonders, they do miracles, they do perform miracles, but they deceive people. You and I need to be careful. The chosen ones will fall, will be deceived by these false prophets, false teachers, false teaching. When Christ Jesus was here, he says, watch out for false prophets. They come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ferocious wolves. The book of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 15. The book of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 15.
Beware of false prophets who come disguised as harmless sheep but are really vicious wolves.
Outside appearance, they are very innocent, they are religious, they are godly. Outside appearance will be like sheep. They come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ferocious wolves. This is what the word of God says. This is what Lord Jesus says about false prophets. Be careful. Watch out. How can you and I discern, test them with the wisdom of this world. You and I need the gift of knowledge, gift of wisdom, gift of discernment. You and I need the gift of the Holy Spirit to test false prophets, to find out their characteristics, dear saints and servants of God. Christ Jesus is coming again into this world very soon. Before Christ Jesus comes into this world, you and I need to be ready. Who are the false prophets and their characteristics? Dear saints and servants of God, Word of God says, what is prophecy? Word of God is called word of prophecy. From Genesis to Revelation, Word of God is called word of prophecy. Holy Spirit is called Spirit of prophecy. Lord has chosen you and I, dear saints and servants of God, for His kingdom to be established, for the glory of Lord Jesus Christ, to win souls. There are three levels of prophet. First level is scriptural. Written word is called logos. The revealed word of God is called rhema. In simple words, Holy Spirit reveals the revelation from the throne of grace. It is called rhema. That's the reason we have a book of Revelation. Revelation from the throne of grace. Revelation from the Spirit of God. John, the revelator, an apostle, the beloved of Lord Jesus Christ. He received the vision. He received the prophecy to the seven churches, to the nations, to the body of Christ in the days to come. Bible talks about past, present, and future. Therefore, where do you and I need to go? Every day prophecy. Every day you shall find prophecy from the Word of God. Word of God is called word of prophecy. From Genesis to Revelation, dear saints and servants of God, there are three levels of prophecy. Number one, scriptural, word-based prophecy. What is the prophecy for you and I today? If you ask me, I will tell you the word of prophecy for you today. You shall receive your reward from the throne of grace if you preach the gospel. If you serve Lord Jesus Christ, where do you find this prophecy? It is found in the book of Revelation, chapter 22, verse 12. This is what the word of God says. They are not the words of my flesh. It is written. Therefore, it is called written word of prophecy. The heaven and the earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away, says the Holy One of Israel. The book of Revelation 22 verse 12 is the word of prophecy. And behold, I'm coming quickly, and my reward is with me to give everyone according to his work. Everything that you do for the kingdom of God, the time, the money that you spend, that you invest in the kingdom of God, there is a reward. There is an earthly reward. Therefore, there is a heavenly reward, physical reward, spiritual reward you shall receive. This is the sure prophecy. What is a prophecy for you? Lord Jesus loves you. Lord Jesus will never leave you nor forsake you. Where it is written in the book of Hebrews chapter 13 verse 6. People say, God is not speaking to me. If you read the word of God every day, God speaks to you through the word of God. If you listen to the word of God every day, God speaks to you through the word of God. Holy Spirit speaks to you and I through the word of God. It is called scriptural. Three levels of prophecy, three levels of prophets. First level is scriptural, scripture-based prophecy. Scripture-based prophet. Second level is called gift of prophecy. When you receive the gift of Holy Spirit reveals the mind of Father. Holy Spirit reveals the mind of Christ. Holy Spirit reveals the will of Father Jehovah to the mankind. We shall find the gift a prophecy in first letter of Corinthians chapter 12. Third level of prophecy, we shall find prophets in the Old Testament. In the Old Testament, we shall see three levels of anointing: priestly anointing, prophets anointing, king's anointing. In the New Testament, we shall see fivefold ministers to edify the body of Christ: apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers. In the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, verse 11, we shall find these five offices to strengthen the body of Christ, to edify the body of Christ, to bring the comfort, to bring the message of comfort, the message of edification, the message of confirmation, the message of truth, to strengthen, to build you, to equip you, and to make you to become like Christ Jesus. Praise be to Jesus. False prophets. Who are the false prophets? They deny the truth. Who are the false prophets? They deny that Jesus Christ of Nazareth came in flesh. They deny the Trinity of God. They deny the doctrine of Christ Jesus. John's first letter, chapter 4, verses 1 to 3. Shall we read?
Dear friends, do not believe everyone who claims to speak by the Spirit. You must test them to see if the Spirit they have comes from God. For there are many false prophets in the world. This is how we know if they have the Spirit of God. If a person claiming to be a prophet acknowledges that Jesus Christ came in a real body, that person has the Spirit of God. But if someone claims to be a prophet and does not acknowledge the truth about Jesus, that person is not from God. Such a person has the spirit of the Antichrist, which you heard is coming into the world and indeed is already here.
Amen. Praise be to Jesus Christ. Glory to the Lamb of God. Dear saints and servants of God, Lord Jesus Christ is coming again into this world very soon. Before he comes into this world, Lord Jesus wants every believer to be used mightily for the kingdom of Lord Jesus. You and I need to know the truth, so the truth shall set us free. False prophets and their characteristics. False prophet denies the truth. False prophet denies Jesus Christ of Nazareth is come in the flesh. That's what the word of God says. Again I say, they reject Christ Jesus' lordship, deity. They reject Jesus Christ of Nazareth, holiness. They reject his sonship. They reject Christ Jesus. If anyone says Jesus is not God, if anyone disagree with the word of God, if anyone disagree with the truth, if anyone disagree with Christ Jesus, if anyone opposes word of God, if anyone stands against Christ Jesus, Bible calls them spirit of Antichrist. They are called Antichrist. They are called false prophets. Praise Jesus. Dear saints and servants of God, they use slick tongues to deceive people. That's why they are called lamb-like beast. They come in sheep clothing, but they are ferocious wolves. That's what the word of God says. What you and I need to do? Test them. Find out their characteristics with the help of the Holy Spirit. They attack spiritual leaders of the local church. They attack believers to deceive them, to lead them into sin. Satan doesn't want heaven to be full. Satan wants heaven to be empty. Satan wants heaven to be empty. That's the reason Satan and the false prophets, demons, come to the church. They come to believers to deceive them, to lead them into sin. The book of Philippians, Paul's letter to Philippians, chapter 3, verse 18.
For I have told you often before, and I say it again with tears in my eyes, that there are many whose conduct shows they are really enemies of the cross of Christ.
Amen. Anyone stands against the cross of Jesus Christ, what do you and I need to call them? They are in sin. They stand against the word of God. They are called enemies of cross. Enemies of Christ Jesus. Dear saints and servants of God, false prophets bring divisions among Christians, among churches, among believers. They deceive people in many ways. John's first letter, chapter 2, verse 22 and 23. Shall we read?
And who is a liar? Anyone who says that Jesus is not the Christ, anyone who denies the Father and the Son is an antichrist. Anyone who denies the Son doesn't have the Father either. But anyone who acknowledges the Son has the Father also.
Amen. False prophets deny Christ Jesus. False prophet denies Father Jehovah. Anyone who does not accept Christ Jesus, they cannot accept Father Jehovah. Christ Jesus is the mediator between heaven and the earth. Christ Jesus is the mediator between God and man. Sin separated man from the power of God, from the love of God, from the garment of righteousness, from the holiness of God. Sin separates you and I from the presence of God. But thanks be to Father for His love, for His grace, for His mercy upon each one. Christ Jesus came into this world to reunite man with God the Father through His blood sacrifice on the cross of Calvary. Praise be to Jesus. What does false prophet do? False prophet denies Christ Jesus. False prophet denies the death of Jesus. False prophet denies the resurrection of Jesus. False prophet denies Christ Jesus' holiness. False prophet denies the truth. False prophet denies that Christ is Son of God. False prophet denies Christ is God. Christ Jesus is the mediator between God and man. Christ Jesus is the omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient. Christ Jesus is living God. Praise be to Jesus. False prophet deceives people. False prophet speaks lies. John the Gospel, chapter 8, verse 44.
For you are the children of your father, the devil, and you love to do the evil things he does. He was a murderer from the beginning. He has always hated the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he lies, it is consistent with his character, for he is a liar and the father of lies.
Amen. False prophet characteristics. They speak lies. They deny the truth. Anyone who speaks lies, who is there in them? Spirit of Satan. That's what the word of God says. He has always hated the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he lies, it is consistent with his character, for he is a liar and the father of lies. That's what the word of God says. False prophet is rebellious and has no teachable spirit. He does not accept truth he does not accept, godly teaching and the teaching from the Holy Spirit. He does not have a teachable spirit. False prophet does not have a heart of receiving, heart of humility, heart of accepting the truth. He is rebellious. The false prophet has gifts but no fruit from the Holy Spirit. Test them, discern their character. They do not show love as Christ Jesus told us when he was here. He said, love your neighbor as thyself. Love comes from God. Where there is a love, there is a spirit of boldness. Where there is a love, there is a spirit of peace. Love of God drives out all fears. What does false prophet do? False prophet brings fear, confusion, division, disturbance, disorder, disunity, depression, loneliness. Rebellious spirit. These are the characteristics of false prophet. They have a gifts, but they do not exercise the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Paul's second letter to Corinthians, chapter 11, verses 14. 13, 14 and 15.
These people are false prophets. They are deceitful workers who disguise themselves as apostles of Christ. But I am not surprised. Even Satan disguises himself as an angel of light. So it is no wonder that his servants also disguise themselves as servants of righteousness. In the end, they will get the punishment their wicked deeds deserve.
Amen. Satan is called an angel of light. Satan represents darkness. Jesus Christ of Nazareth came into this world to seek and to save the lost. John the Gospel chapter 8 verse 12 says, Jesus Christ of Nazareth is the light of the world. Therefore, he wants us to be the light of this world. You are the salt and light of this world. When light comes, darkness flees. False prophet acts themselves like an angel of light. John's second letter, chapter 1, verse 7.
I say this because many deceivers have gone out into the world. They deny that Jesus Christ came in a real body. Such a person is a deceiver and an antichrist.
Amen. We shall find many people in this world, they deny Christ Jesus. In Africa, there are many tribes, there are many languages. In India, 1,653 languages are there. In India, there are 29 states are there. Indian population is crossing 700 billion. Yes, total population of the whole world is 700 billion. Only Indian population is crossing 130 billion. Dear saints and servants of God, they have it. 33 millions of gods and goddesses in India alone. When it comes to African continent, in African continent, there are 44 nations. There are many languages. Each country has many tribes, languages, traditions, cultures. They have polygamy in Africa. Dear saints and servants of God, what does Bible say? Does Bible accept the polygamy? Does Bible accept the idol worship, idolatry? No. False prophet leads people into sin, into wickedness. They have no roots, no spiritual ties. They lead people into sin. They bring fear, confusion, disturbance, wicked things, culture, tradition, customs, blind beliefs of the tribe, tradition in local territory. Spirit of the Lord, help me to travel 14 nations in Africa. I lived with them, with the local tribes. Every year I go to Africa and I live in Africa for more than 1 month. Just because of COVID pandemic situation, I'm not going since 1.5 years. Dear saints and servants of God, I used to live with the Africans, different tribes, different traditions. I find false prophets in Africa, in Asia, more. Because I travel and I live with them. I lived in forest. I lived with them in the caves. I had a meal with them. I lived with Maasai. I lived with the Tutus, Tulsis. They are the tribes in Africa. Dear saints and servants of God, what does false prophet do? They lead people into sin. They are rebellious. They are not teachable. They deny the truth. They speak lies. They come to people like lamb, like beast. They are called the servants of Satan. The book of Philippians, chapter 3, verses 18. They are the enemies of cross.
For I have told you often before, and I say it again with tears in my eyes, that there are many whose conduct shows they are really enemies of the cross of Christ.
Amen. They are called enemies of cross. We shall find many religious leaders, religious people in different nations. They kill, they persecute the righteous and the followers of Christ Jesus. And they say, we are doing it for the sake of God. They take the name of God. John the Gospel chapter 16 verse 2 reveals the truth to the mankind. John the Gospel chapter 16 verse 2. They will put you out of the synagogues. Yes, the time is coming that whoever kills you will think that he offers God service. This is what people say in the last days. Dear saints and servants of God, you and I need to test them, discern them with the help of the Holy Spirit. We are talking about false prophets and their characteristics. Peter's second letter, chapter 2, verses 1 to 3. Apostle Peter's second letter, chapter 2, verses 1 to 3.
But there were also false prophets in Israel, just as there will be false teachers among you. They will cleverly teach destructive heresies and even deny the master who bought them. In this way, they will bring sudden destruction on themselves. Many will follow their evil teaching and shameful immorality. And because of these teachers, the way of the truth will be slandered. In their greed, they will make up clever lies to get hold of your money. But God condemned them long ago, and their destruction will not be delayed.
Amen. Praise be to Jesus. They were there during the time of Christ Jesus. They were there in Israel. They were there when the chosen generation was in Egypt. When God performed miracles through prophet Moses, God's servant Moses, The Egyptians did black magic. They did wonders through the power of Satan. False prophets did miracles in Egypt during the time of Moses and the Israelites in Egypt. False prophets do perform miracles, do perform signs and the wonders with the power of Satan. But you and I need to test. What is the greatest miracle on this planet Earth? The gift of salvation is the greatest miracle, dear saints and servants of God. Mostly people run behind the physical miracles. When Christ was here on this planet Earth, millions followed Christ Jesus to receive physical miracles. Similarly today, I'm not against healing miracles, dear saints and servants of God, but you and I need to test their life, their character, their integrity, their belief system. Whom do they believe? Whom do they believe? Do they believe in the truth? False prophets were there during the time of Christ Jesus. Lord Jesus was saying, many will come in my name, but do not be deceived. In the book of Matthew chapter 24, verse 11. The book of Matthew chapter 24, verse 11.
For many will come in my name, claiming I am the Messiah. They will deceive many.
Amen. They deceive people. They claim themselves as servants of living God. They deceive people. They lead people into sin. They blaspheme God. They talk against the living God. They take personal glory. They were led by the flesh and Satan. They walk in darkness. They have no integrity. False prophet brings all kinds of fears. False prophet brings destruction. False prophet brings curses. False prophets are mindful of earthly things. They do not believe in Trinity. They bring false doctrines. They look for the praises from people. They are happy when men please them. God wants us to please Him. They blaspheme God. During the time of 7 years tribulation, we shall find false prophet who works along with Antichrist. They do perform miracles, healings with the help of Satan. They are called beast in the book of Revelation chapter 13. Beast from sea, beast from people. First beast is called Antichrist. Second beast in the book of Revelation chapter 13 is called false prophet. Satan has Trinity. Satan works along with Antichrist and false prophet during the time of 7 years tribulation. They perform miracles with the power and the strength of Satan. They have no testimony, no character, no holiness. They are hypocrites. They take personal glory. In the book of Revelation chapter 13, they look for the worship. False prophet who works with Antichrist in the book of Revelation chapter 13. They force people to worship the image of Antichrist during the time of 7 years tribulation. They blaspheme God. They claim themselves. Antichrist claims himself as God, becomes ruler of 10 kingdoms, and starts his authority from Jerusalem. That's what the word of God says in the book of Revelation, chapter 13. Shall we read Thessalonians, second letter to Thessalonians, chapter 2, verse 7, 8, 9, and 10. Second book of Thessalonians. Second book of Thessalonians, chapter 2, verses 7 to 10.
For this lawlessness is already at work secretly, and it will remain secret until the one who is holding it back steps out of the way. Then the man of lawlessness will be revealed, but the Lord Jesus will slay him with the breath of his mouth and destroy him by the splendor of his coming. This man will come to do the work of Satan with the counterfeit powers and signs and miracles.
Amen.
He will use every kind of evil deception to fool those on their way to destruction, because they refuse to love and accept the truth that would save them.
Amen. Praise be to Jesus. What does false prophet does along with Antichrist? They bring wickedness. They bring lawlessness. They bring wickedness. He is called man of wickedness. He will use every kind of evil deception to fool those on their way to destruction, because they refuse to love and accept the truth that they would save them. They deny the love of God. They deny the truth from the word of God. Dear saints and servants of God, how to test them? How to discern false prophets? How to discern false prophets' characteristics? Christ Jesus knows our weakness. That's the reason we have a blessed Holy Spirit. His name is Helper. He is our companion. He is our helper. He abides. Holy Spirit abides in us forever. He leads people into truth. He guides us into truth. Holy Spirit glorifies the name of Father Jehovah. Holy Spirit reveals the truth to the mankind. Holy Spirit lifts the name of Jesus Christ above every name. Holy Spirit is our guide. Holy Spirit is our strength. Holy Spirit is our teacher. The anointing teaches us everything through the word of God. Praise be to Jesus. But the question to you is, do you accept the truth? Do you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and personal Savior? Do you accept and agree with the word of God? Do you agree with the Holy Spirit? Do you believe and agree with the doctrine of Trinity? Do you agree with the doctrine of Christ? Do you agree with the doctrine of Holy Spirit? Do you agree with the full gospel truth? Dear saints and servants of God, Christ Jesus is coming again into this world. Before he comes into this world, he wants us to know the truth. False prophet denies the church administration. False prophet denies the accountability. False prophet denies the submission to the local church authority. False prophet denies the truth. False prophet rejects the love of Christ. False prophet leads people into disturbance. When there is a false prophecy, when there is a false prophecy, there will be confusion, there will be fear, there'll be threatening, there'll be disturbance, there'll be destruction. Word of God helps us. Holy Spirit reveals the truth to you and I, dear saints and servants of God. First book of Corinthians, chapter 6, verses 19 and 20.
Don't you realize that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, who lives in you and was given to you by God? You do not belong to yourself, for God bought you with a high price, so you must honor God with your body.
Amen. You do not belong to you. You do not belong to this world. People say, my body, I do as I wish. No. Word of God says, you and I need to glorify our Father Jehovah through our body. You and I need to glorify our Lord Jesus Christ through our body, because Christ Jesus purchased you and I with his precious blood that he shed on the cross of Calvary. Therefore, we do not belong to this world. We do not belong to ourselves. We belong to Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus purchased you and I. Therefore, glorify his holy name. False prophets do not glorify the name of Jesus Christ. False prophets do not glorify our Father Jehovah. False prophets lead people into sin. Dear saints and servants of God, Christ Jesus loves you so much. Do not be afraid. Do not worry about the false prophets. Spirit of the Lord is going to help you and I. Christ Jesus is coming again into this world. What you and I need to do? Come to the throne of grace to receive the help. Help comes to you and I from the grace of Lord Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit helps you and I, because Christ Jesus is coming again very soon into this world. Before he comes into this world, the body of Christ should be ready. Christ Jesus is coming for the Holy One, holy people. Christ Jesus is coming for the believers. In his secret coming, Christ Jesus is coming for the righteous ones. Holy Spirit leads us into truth. Holy Spirit gives us the conviction of sin. Holy Spirit gives us the conviction of the truth. Holy Spirit gives us the conviction of sin, righteousness, and judgment. Holy Spirit reveals the truth to you and I. Jesus is Son of God. Jesus Christ of Nazareth died on the cross and rose again after 3 days. Do you believe in Jesus? Do you believe that Christ Jesus is coming again to take the body of Christ to be with him forever? Do you believe that you have a reward if you believe and serve his holy name? Believe and receive your miracle today. Word of God says, without faith it is impossible to please God. He that comes to God should believe in heart that he is the rewarder of those who diligently seek him. He loves you. He will change your situation. He wants you. Spirit of the Lord wants to fill us with his love, with his word, for his glory. Let his will be done. Let thy will be done. Thy kingdom come. Thy name be glorified in us, through us, through the power of the Holy Spirit. Shall we pray? Father, we come to you through the blood of Jesus. Thank you, dear Holy Spirit of God, for helping us to know the false prophets and their characteristics. Thank you, dear Holy Spirit of God, for your mighty presence in our lives. We believe in miracles. We believe in healings. We believe in what Jesus Christ of Nazareth has done on the cross of Calvary. We believe that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is the healer. We believe Jesus is Mighty One of Israel. Jesus Christ of Nazareth is Son of Living God. We believe in our hearts. Christ Jesus died on the cross and rose again after 3 days. Jesus is the Lord of our lives. Jesus is the Lord of our future. Thank you, dear Holy Spirit of God, for revealing the truth to the mankind. Thank you for helping each one to proclaim and declare that Christ Jesus is the Lord of all. Jesus Christ of Nazareth is coming again Thank you for preparing each one to be used mightily for the kingdom of Lord Jesus Christ. Let your will be done. Let your kingdom come. Let your name be exalted in us and through us. Every fear, every confusion, every disturbance, every weakness, every sickness, every spirit of false prophecy, every spirit of false prophet, every false teaching, every spirit of antichrist, every spirit of death and hates, every spirit of Apollyon, every spirit of Jezebel, I command you to leave the place, people, now in Jesus' name. We declare we are under the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Jesus is the Lord of our lives. Holy Spirit is our helper. Christ Jesus is alive inside of us. Thank you, Jesus, for your lordship in our lives. Thank you, dear Holy Spirit, for your continual help in our lives. We thank you for your grace upon each one. Thank you for preparing each one to go into all the world to preach the gospel, to proclaim the gospel to the poor and needy. Jesus is coming again. We love you. We bless you. In Jesus' name we agree and we pray. Amen. Shalom.